Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're glad you guys all came tonight to support the kids and to see what they've done. We have a special social studies fair planned for you this evening. We have a program with our music teacher, Mrs. Decker, who's been with us for quite some time now. And I've been really impressed with how much the kids have learned about music from this lady. Last year at this time, they were doing the drums as well, and they've got another drum performance for you tonight. And I'm just amazed at how much they've grown with their musical knowledge this year and with their ability to know rhythms and that kind of thing. So we're excited to see them do their drumming, and we're excited to see the lower grade students sing a couple of songs that are related to Europe. And then we also have another European presentation for you. And then they also have their boards, and they've all have speeches that they have prepared for you for their board. So I hope that you'll take the time to visit each board. But let's begin our evening with prayer. Let's pray. Father in heaven, Lord, thank you so much for our school, for these families, and for these boys and girls who have worked hard to prepare this social studies fair tonight. May it be a blessing for not only the performers, but also for the families who watch. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hello, my name is David, and what we're going to talk about today is here's the picture of the United Kingdom, and here's Scotland. And that's where we're going to talk about today.
There are over 900 islands of Scotland, and only 20 of them people can live on because most of them are small and have cliffs on them. And we are going to be singing about Sky today.
Hello, my name is Joaquin, and today I will be talking about kilts. Kilts can be used for many things. A kilt can be used for a blanket. A kilt can be used for a sweater, and you can just wear it. This is a kilt. The kilts have family tartans. Each family has their own tartan. Each tartan is different. Most of the time, they wear sporrans on their kilts. A sporran is like a bag, and it's made out of leather.
The highlands and lowlands are different places. The highlands are higher and the lowlands are lower. I took out the rest. More people live in the highlands and less people live in the lowlands. More people live in the lowlands and less people live in the highlands.
This is a bagpipe, and you blow out this top one, and you make music out of them. You squeeze the bottom, and then it sounds like a drone underneath.
And bagpipes are also used for war. When the person who is playing them dies, then one person will drop their weapons and pick it up and play it.
Scotland tried to leave the United Kingdom two times. The last one was in 1746.
Nessie was a sea monster, and they believed she was alive, but they didn't know she wasn't, because it wasn't not real.
A folk song is a story that is transformed into a song that tells stories from around the world. Today we will be singing two of them.
Oh, we take the high road and I'll take the low. The bagpipes were first used by the Irish army, and the bagpipes were created in the 13th century, and the bagpipes came from Scotland and are now mostly used in Western Europe. In order to play the bagpipes, you need to blow into the first pipe, then with your elbows, squeeze the bag in there, will come out from the four other pipes, which will make them.
Then you will need your fingers on the fourth pipe to change the notes. The popularity was boosted by the military service in World War I and World War II. The Highland bagpipe is commonly used and is mostly played during ceremonies. Many police services and firemen in Scotland, Canada, Austria, New Zealand, Hong Kong, and the United States have adopted the tradition of pipe bands.
Christian was the first American yodeler. Yodeling was invented in 1545. Yodeling developed into singing in the 1930s. The whole world was yodeling. Yodeling is a way to call from one mountain to another. Yodeling was invented in Switzerland.
Oh, The accordion is a portable piano keyboard that wind instrument in which the wind is forced past free reeds by means of a hand-operated bellows that was invented in Berlin, Germany in 1822 by Cyril Demain and Frederick Buschmann, and it is about 200 years old.
The Alphorn was either from Germany or Switzerland. Konrad Gesner was the first person to describe it. You blow it like a trumpet. It originated in 1555.
The Alphorn is made from softwood, generally spruce but sometimes pine. Modern makers piece the wood together to form the base.
Kilts first started in the 16th century. The people of the Scottish Highlands were the first people to wear kilts. Kilts are popular in other Celtic nations. The kilt first appeared as the Great Kilt, which is a large blanket, like a piece of fabric. It is called a kilt because it is taken from a Norse word that means pleated.
Lederhosen translates to leather pants in Germany. They were invented in the 18th century and were created as workwear for peasants. They are made of tan deer leather, and it was originated in the southern German region of Bavaria.
St. Bernard dogs would rescue people who were buried under the snow and lie on top of them to provide warmth. They were originally bred to protect the hospice residents and are rescue dogs. The dog soon began to display remarkable abilities like rescuing travelers. They would carry whiskey to aid stranded travelers.
Hello, everybody. Today I will be telling you about castanets. Did you know castanets, also known as clackers or palillos, are a percussion instrument? And you might be wondering who invented them. The invention of the castanets is attributed to the Phoenicians. It was created more than 3,000 years ago. It is made out of common wood or plastic, and it is tied together with string. And thank you for your time, and I hope you all have fun.
No, I'm ready. The first real Pysanky egg was found in northern Ukraine that dates back to the 17th century. Legends blend folklore and Christian beliefs that firmly attach the egg to the Easter celebration. Pysanky eggs are made by writing with hot colored wax on goose eggs. The Ukrainian people use this as a tradition to make the long winters less harsh.
A baguette is a French bread. Nobody knows who created it first.
The history of the French baguette is not completely known. Several myths have been spread about the origins of this type of bread.
Some say Napoleon Bonaparte created the French baguette.
Other stories credit baguette as being an invention to stop French metro workers from having to carry knives that they used to cut their bread.
The workers fought a lot. They did not want them to be carrying knives.
British afternoon tea was started in 1890. It is a British tradition. It was introduced in England by Anna, the 7th Duchess of Bedford. She created afternoon tea because she got tired of being hungry between lunch at noon and supper at 8 o'clock.
Afternoon tea can include sandwiches, scones, and cake. It came from England.
The actual beginning of cheese rolling is unknown. However, it is thought to have begun in the 1800s. No one has actually caught the cheese wheel. No one has ever been killed at a cheese roll. It started at Gloucester in England.
Lefto was first made by Norwegians. It first originated in Viking time. When Scandinavians made it, they sometimes put eggs and ham on it. Most of the time it is eaten around Thanksgiving and Christmas time.
The home of the world's largest lefse is in the town of Starbucks, Minnesota. It was made on July 1st, 1983. Families in Norway tend to purchase their lefse rather than making it in their homes.
Stabburet cookies were the first originating in Norway. They are one of Norway's most popular crackers. Today, 28 Stabburet cookies remain. The reason they are called Stabburet cookies is because they have rods in them made of wood called stabs, hence the name. And all Stabburet cookies are built with just wood.
This concludes our program, but the students have boards that they've prepared, and they'll be at their boards for the next 20 minutes or so you can wander around. Please be sure to ask them to say their speeches because they worked hard at memorizing them. So I'm going to dismiss them now to go to their boards. And after they're at their boards, we would love for you to go join them. And after you have enjoyed walking around the boards, we have some cookies and some lemonade for you.